Good afternoon, all of you. So my name is Ramakrishna. So I am working in St. Martin Engineering College. So my experience is 6 years. So today my topic is polymers. So polymers. So first of all, this polymer word is a Greek word, right? So poly means many. So mers means parts. So what is a polymer? So polymer nothing but many parts or many units, right? So then first of all here some small definitions are there. So first a polymer, after polymerization, right? So monomer. So first of all, what is a polymer? So polymer nothing but so small units converted to large units, right? So what is a polymer? So polymer nothing but small units converted to large units, right? So then as well as so low molecular weight converted to high molecular weight, so is called polymers, right? So this is a simply definition of polymers, right? So examples one should observe. So here what take ethylene example, ethylene, so CH2 double bond CH2. So this is a small unit. So this small unit converted to so CH2 double bond in the single bond. So CH2. So this is a so polymer, right? So here one more to add ethene CH2 double bond CH2, right? So here what happened? Chain growth so increase, right? So then after that, so here attached to 4 carbons. So like that. So one more to add. Ethylene CH2 double bond CH2. Okay, so again what happened? Increase to chain CH2 single bond CH2 single bond CH2 single bond, so CH2, so CH2 single bond CH2, right? So how many carbons? So 1 2 3 4 5 6, 1 2 3 4 5 6, right? So here what happened? So once observe here, so this is small unit, right? So this small unit then converted to large unit, right? So this is called polymer. This is called polymer, right? So this is simply what, right? Also what indicate? So in exam what happened? So the less time is there, right? So that's why here auto and there auto shortcut. So shortcut nothing but so simply here auto indicate n. So n nothing but number of monomers. So number of monomers converted to polymers. Number of monomers converted to polymers, right? So that's why then this polymer what write in bracket. So write down in down N, right? So N nothing but here. So number of polymers. Number of polymers, right? So this is simply shortcut method what write. So N nothing but number of monomers. Number of monomers converted to number of polymers. So E is called polymers. Clear? So after that, so polymerization. So what is the polymerization? So polymerization. What is the definition of polymerization? So polymerization nothing but so two or more monomers so combined form a polymer. So E is called polymerization. Right? Clear? So what is the definition? So two or more monomers combined form a polymer. So E is called polymerization. It's called polymerization, right? So what is the definition of polymerization? Two or more monomers combined form a polymer. E is called polymerization. So here examples. So more examples are there. So ethene. So vinyl chloride. So styrene. Etc. Right? So these are so two or more monomers combined form a polymer, right? So this is called polymerization. So next topic is so types of polymerization. So types of polymerization. So three types of polymerizations are there. So first one is addition polymerization. And the second one is condensation polymerization. And the third one is copolymerization. Right? So total, so types of polymerization, total three types are there. So one is the addition polymerization. So second one is the condensation polymerization and third one is copolymerization, right? So addition polymerization, one more name is there, that is called chain growth polymerization. Chain growth polymerization. Then as well as condensation also one more name is there, that is a step growth polymerization. Step growth polymerization, right? So clear? So here I want to discuss one by one. So first we'll discuss the addition polymerization. What is addition polymerization? So addition polymerization or chain growth polymerization. So simply you have to remember, already you know what is a polymerization. So polymerization nothing but two or more monomers combined form a polymer is called polymerization, right? So same like here also, addition polymerization nothing but two or more monomers combined form a polymer without elimination. Without elimination is called addition polymerization. What is that? Two or more monomers combined form a polymer. So combined form a polymer without elimination is called addition polymerization. So this is called chain growth polymerization also, right? So here examples. So ethylene, here what to take example, ethylene, so vinyl chloride, styrene, so etc. More examples are there, right? So once what to see addition polymerization. So ethylene structure. So this is ethylene structure, CH2 double bond, CH2, right? So this is ethylene. So this ethylene converted to n moles of ethylene. So entire this is converted to polyethylene. CH2 single bond, CH2. So right? So this simply here what happened? This double bond break, then converted to single bond. Okay. So this is ethylene converted to polymer. So this is a polyethylene. So this is an addition polymer. Once this reaction what observed, so any byproduct is there? No. So that's why this is what happened, without elimination takes place, right? So lighter reactions you can call addition polymerization. Okay. So next example, once what observed, CH2 double bond, CHCl. So this is vinyl chloride. So vinyl chloride, so n type of vinyl chloride converted to polyvinyl chloride. CH2 double bond, single bond. So CHCl then converted to polymer. Right? So here once observe here. So what is that? This is a vinyl chloride. So this vinyl chloride converted to polyvinyl chloride. Clear? So one more example also is there. So polystyrene. So double bond. So CH benzene ion. Right? So this is converted to single bond. Right? So this is, so styrene converted to polystyrene. So here one should observe these three reactions, so very easy. So here this one, so ethene what observe, so CH2 double bond, CH2 is there. So one hydrogen excess. So here one hydrogen want to remove, then add chlorine. So that is vinyl chloride. So chlorine remove, add benzene. So that is styrene, right? So like that simply want to remember, right? So these all things are, so which is a polymer, this which type of reaction this is? Polymer, addition polymerization, right? Or chain growth polymerization, right? So addition polymerization or chain growth polymerization. So why? Because, so here without elimination takes place. Any byproduct is there? So no. So that's why, so these all reactions you can call addition polymerization. Clear? So this is the first one. So second one is condensation polymerization. Second one is condensation polymerization. right? So first, what is the definition of condensation polymerization? So condensation polymerization nothing but quite opposite addition polymerization, right? So what is addition polymerization? Two or more monomers combined form a polymer without elimination is called addition polymerization, right? So what is the condensation polymerization? Two or more monomers combined form a with elimination, right? So is called condensation polymerization. Clear? So with elimination nothing but so byproduct is there, right? So here examples are, so best examples are there. So first example is the bakelite. So nylon 6,6. So urea formaldehyde resin. So more examples are there. But so this is a very very important these two. So first we'll discuss bakelite. Examples of bakelite. So once we'll not see. So what is the condensation polymerization? So condensation. What is another name? So step growth, right? So step growth polymerization. So now we'll discuss bakelite. Preparation of bakelite. So preparation of bakelite, one should observe a flow chart is there. So flow chart, first a phenol and a formaldehyde. So phenol and formaldehyde. So in the presence of acid or alcohol, then converted to monomethyl or phenol. So monomethyl phenol react with phenol in the presence of phenol. So converted to novalac. Right? So novalac then converted to bakelite. So this is a simply flow chart. So first phenol and formaldehyde in the presence of acid. So that is converted to monomethyl phenol. So monomethyl phenol react with phenol then converted to novalac. So after that novalac then form bakelite, right? So this is a flow chart. First we will discuss one by one. So step one, formation of monomethyl phenol. Okay, so formation of monomethyl phenol, right? So this is simply first, what is the formaldehyde structure? So formaldehyde structure, so H C double bond O H, right? So in the presence of acid, as you know, here what is like H plus ion, right? So this is converted to carbocation. So C OH H carbocation, right? So this carbocation react with phenol. So this is a phenol structure. So this is a react with carbocation H COH H carbocation, right? So this carbocation then reacted to here in ortho position. Okay, so this is called monomethyl phenol. So this is monomethyl phenol, right? So for example, here we have to take 2 moles of carbocations. So that time was converted to dimethyl phenol, right? One sort of C. So this is phenol structure. So here we have to take 2 moles of formaldehyde carbocation, then converted to dimethyl phenol. CH2OH, right? So only, so this is a monomethyl, this is dimethyl, clear? So this is the formation of monomethyl. This is step one. So next one is a step two. So what is the step two? Formation of novalac. formation of nolac. Step 2. Stop there.